Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
Cutter Family Auto Centers present Ohana Road, Hawaii's automotive TV magazine. Featuring all the latest and greatest cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs coming your way. A visit with celebrity car enthusiasts. A look at fabulous classics and cars of tomorrow. Meet local stars and cars. All that and a bunch of Maloney. Right here on Ohana Road. With your hosts, Dale Payson and Anita Hall.
Aloha, everyone, and welcome once again to Ohana Road, Hawaii's premier automotive infotainment TV show. I'm Dale Payson, and we have a cool show for you tonight. In fact, Anita Hall and I will be shining the new car spotlight on what we call cool coupes. We'll show you some of the latest two-door personal cars from Chrysler, General Motors, and Volkswagen, as well as a peek at a cool new concept coupe. Then on Car Mania, we'll introduce you to an auto racing icon, Dan Gurney, and a first look at his brand new high-performance motorcycle, the Alligator. On Concepts and Classics, we'll head to Italy and the famous Bologna Auto Show for a look at the latest from the Euros, including a $2 million Ferrari. And on Hawaii Stars and Cars, it's Pee-Pee from FM 100 as he has some fun at Toys for Tots. All that plus a bunch of Maloney. So open something cool. Tonight's edition of Ohana Road takes off right after this.
Master, what is the meaning of life?
Cars cost less at Cutter.
When you get real name brand auto parts, you get real auto value.
Would you install these parts in your car? Get real. Get real name brand auto parts at your Hawaii Auto Value Parts Store, where ASC certified counter pros will get you the parts you need at the value you expect. We carry name brand original equipment parts for all import and domestic cars and trucks. Visit the Auto Value location nearest you today.
When you get real name brand auto parts, you get real auto value.
Hey, you ready yet?
Dude, I forgot my towel.
Don't worry. I got my assets covered. Dude, I'm sorry.
Wet Acole seat covers. It's like having a wetsuit for your seats. They're waterproof, snagproof, and stainproof. Ask for the original by name. Wet Acole.
Most people know that a coupe is a two-door car. The Dictionary of Automotive Terms defines a coupe as an enclosed single compartment body with two doors and varying passenger capacity depending upon seating arrangements. The word is French, thus the spelling coupe, which I think sounds kind of cool all by itself. Of course, there are different types of coupes: hatchback coupes, convertible coupes, 2+2 coupes, that means it has a back seat, and a two-door sport coupe like this very cool Chrysler Crossfire. With European styling and a Mercedes engine, the Crossfire also comes in a convertible, making this two-seater coupe into a roadster.
Chrysler Crossfire Roadster is the company's determination to offer a two-seat convertible that's comparable to European and Japanese for performance and wind-in-your-face enthusiasts. As a glamorous head-turning version of the Crossfire Coupe, the Roadster displays the ultimate expression of the Chrysler brand. With a 215-horsepower V6 engine, the Crossfire Roadster gets up and goes with true sports car results. The retro-looking Crossfire is built in Germany in conjunction with Karmann. The Crossfire Roadster is built with a soft fabric top that opens and closes in short order. A retractable spoiler is designed into the rear of the vehicle and activates when the car reaches 60 miles per hour. The center high-mounted stop lamp runs the width of the deployable rear spoiler. The Chrysler Crossfire Roadster, for those who want the wind in their face.
We're talking about cool coupes, and here's Anita with one of the world's most popular two-doors from Volkswagen. Anita?
Thanks, Dale. Volkswagen's newest entry in the subcompact performance category is a head-turner. The GTI version of this new Golf Sport is a 200 horsepower, turbocharged four, and even the color's fast, tornado red. It's also available in a 1.9-liter TDI version.
For the new model year, you can select a Volkswagen Golf to match your driving style and needs. The 2006 lineup offers three models in two trim levels, the Volkswagen Golf GL 2.0-liter and Golf GLS 2.0-liter and GLS TDI. The 2006 Golf GLS 2-liter offers many of the same features as the Golf TDI, with one obvious exception. Volkswagen's 2-liter four-cylinder gasoline engine is used in place of the diesel engine. The EPA fuel economy rating for the Golf GL and GLS 2-liter is up to 31 miles per gallon highway and 24 miles per gallon city. In hatchback configuration, the Golf optimizes passenger space as it seats 5 and has a cargo volume of 42 cubic feet. Rear window wiper and 15-inch all-season radial tires are standard, as is the Monsoon sound system. Of course, as with all Volkswagens, style and dependability are givens.
And this Golf, of course, is one fun car to drive. You can really toss it around. At the track, of course. We want to say thanks to the great staff at Cutter Volkswagen Ala Moana for making this rocket available to us to share with you. Dale?
Thanks, Anita. On a previous installment of Ohana Road, Barry McGuire introduced us to American racing legend Dan Gurney. During his fabulous career, Gurney competed in everything from stock cars to Formula One, but few knew that his real passion was motorcycles. Now in his retirement, he decided to design and build his dream bike, and he calls it the Alligator. With special permission from the Speed Channel, here's this week's installment of Car Mania and the story of Dan and the Alligator.
There's no disputing that Daniel Sexton Gurney is one of the best-loved personalities in American motorsports. Dan's done it all, winning in Formula One, Indy cars, stock and sports cars, but he's not about to consider retirement. That's because Dan is a motorcycle nut. His famous All-American Racers shop in Santa Ana, California, is where 90% of one year's Indy 500 grid qualified in Gurney Eagles. It's here that he's designed and built the Alligator Sport Touring Bike. This special bike sports a Honda four-stroke fuel-injected engine, coupled with a low center of gravity, creating an awesome acceleration and a fun riding machine. He's already built and sold 36 copies. Motorcyclist magazine called the Alligator outrageous, unexpected, and completely original. Now Dan has produced a new prototype with a Harley S and SV twin 124 cubic inch engine mated to a 6-speed gearbox. Introduced to the motorcycling press at the Peterson Automotive Museum by Dan himself, who brought the Alligator out of its shell. The Speed Channel was on hand to cover the event. Dan's son, racer Justin Gurney, says he loves the Alligator. At $35,000 each, this is a machine for the purist who wants something unique, a true enthusiast motorcycle. To Dan Gurney, Ohana Road says mahalo for the memories, and may you continue to rock and ride.
Lucky butt. Come on, butt.
You can do it just one time.
Dude, I forgot my towel.
Don't worry. I got my assets covered.
Sorry.
Weta Cole seat covers. It's like having a wetsuit for your seats. They're waterproof, snagproof, and stainproof. Ask for the original by name. Weta Cole.
Celebrate Brew Moon's 5th anniversary with our Brewer's Blast. From now till the end of summer, happy hour on the moon all day and all night with $3 beers. Lunch, dinner, and late night dining with high quality microbrews, great poo-poos, and live music Tuesday through Saturday. Brew Moon, come for the beer, stay for the fun. Second level Ward Center. See you at the moon.
In the automobile world, we are in what they call the season, the auto show season. The first big U.S. auto show is the Greater Los Angeles Auto Show. In fact, we'll be devoting an entire episode of Ohana Road to the L.A. Auto Show coming up in a few more weeks. And you don't want to miss it. But the first major international auto show happens to be in beautiful Bologna, Italy, where the cars are hot, but the temperature is freezing. So bundle up and join us now for a peek at how the Euros do it on this week's Concepts and Classics.
The Bologna Auto Show takes place every December in chilly Italy and is this year celebrating its 30th anniversary. Bologna, now considered a major international show, is famous for displaying the Italian passion for the automobile and is attended by over 1 million people during 9 days. This year, the passion not only filled the displays of new models, but also spilled over into the outside arena, where a small racetrack had been constructed. The temperatures outside were below freezing, but that didn't deter spectators from enjoying the up-close action of an 800-horsepower Ferrari Formula One race car making the circuit, being careful not to unleash too many ponies at once. Whoa, easy on that throttle. For the finale, it was time for some victory donuts, and the crowd loved it. Fans were also treated to a World Rally Car Exhibition Race as a handful of compact rally cars zipped around the track, dicing for position. In the end, there was even a bit of drifting action just for the fans. Back inside, there were lots of displays. Some familiar American brands were represented, although many of the models are exclusive to Europe, like the Chevy Nobira. Volkswagen showed off its latest for the European market, including the new EOS convertible. And Mitsubishi also showcased its Euro models. There were brands that are no longer imported to our country, like these beautiful Alfa Romeos. And a popular little Italian import of the 1960s and 70s, no longer sold in America, Fiat, was launching two models. Mahindra from India builds a line of small SUVs sold mostly in parts of Africa, Asia, and some European and Latin American countries. From France, Citroën showed off its new concept car. If you haven't heard, the Chinese are now building cars, and Great Wall Motors also chose Bologna for the European launch of its two models, an SUV called the Hover and a pickup called the Deer. By the way, the cars might be from China, but the girls are from Italy. But the passion of Bologna was most evident in the Italian-built cars like the luxurious Maseratis. The exotic Lambos were there, dressed in their finest white pearl paint jobs. But the national pride of Italy is still Ferrari, decked out in its famous red paint and sporting the Prancing Stallion logo. And the latest from this Italian icon is the new Ferrari FXX. This 800-horsepower supercar is not street legal, but if your application is accepted, you get to buy one of about 20 to be built. The price tag? About $2 million. Should we put your order in now?
Time to trade the traveling shoes for some good old rubber slippers as we come back to the islands and catch up with one of my old radio buddies from FM 100's morning show. It's Pee-Pee having fun at Toys for Tots on this week's Hawaii Stars and Cars.
Hawaii Stars and Cars, brought to you by Hawaii's newspaper. Find your next great deal on wheels in the advertiser's Hawaii's Cars section.
Connecting, it's what we do, with local stories that take you there as life unfolds. The Honolulu Advertiser is here for you, 24 hours a day, with nearly 900 dedicated employees bringing you the stories you want and the values you need. We're here to keep that fun. The Honolulu Advertiser, Hawaii's newspaper. Shift into overdrive and find the right of your life every Sunday in Hawaii's Cars. It's the best and brightest auto section around, now in the Sunday Honolulu Advertiser.
Dale, check this car out, my brother. Oh, I'm over here with Randall, the owner of this huge beast. Can you tell me a little bit about your car over here? Because it definitely looks like it's got some muscle under the hood.
No, it's a 1952 Chevy Bel Air hot top. We're on 301, punched out 283. Two carburetors and a blower scoop.
Oh my gosh, okay, if you don't know what that means, it's just a lot of gas that's going down the drain, okay? Hey Randall, gotta ask you real quick, okay? What does IHRA stand for right there on your license plate?
International Hot Rod Association.
Tell me about these other cars that are cruising with us right now, especially this blue one right here.
Yeah, 66 Nova. We're on 355 cubic inch, running tunnels with dual carburetors, poly carburetors.
Yeah, this is all sweet, man. And what about this other yellow one right here?
A 1957 Chevy.
Bel Air?
Yeah, that's on Bel Air. That's one two-door hardtop.
You know, my father had one just like it, you know. Is it okay if I check the serial numbers or?
You can check them all. You like check out the motor. Hey, Donald, we can check your motor out.
Yeah, we like check out the motor on this one, bro. We like check out the motor. Open it up. Woo, baby, check this out. Come over here. Okay, what was your name again?
My name's Donald.
Brother Donald running this beautiful yellow lemon car. It's not a lemon, huh?
No, it's a Corvette yellow.
It's a Corvette yellow. Okay, I was just wondering, maybe that was the color, the name of the color. What do we have here? What are we looking at?
It's a stock 350, a small cam. 4-speed gears, not for the street.
Okay, so you guys are saying, a lot of people say, oh no, we're not in any club, but how come you're not in a club, man?
We just want to be independent. Go where we want, free, and just let our wives be the bosses.
Let the wives be the bosses, yeah, as long as you're air conditioned. Does this car have AC?
Negative.
Oh my gosh, man. Are you still married?
I hope so.
Okay. We got all different kind of guys, all different kind of cars, all here for one reason, Toys for Tots. Back to you, Dale.
PP, you always crack me up. Mahalo, brother. If you just joined us, hey, you missed some good stuff. Our new car theme this week is cool coupes, and one of the coolest new models at this year's LA Auto Show turned out to be Pontiac's G6 Coupe.
The all-new Pontiac G6 challenges the look and feel of sporty mid-size cars. Its contemporary design beams with sensuous styling and athletic proportions. Last year, we had the G6 sedan. You may recall that was the car Oprah gave to everyone on her show. Now it's back as a hardtop convertible. The G6 coupe and hardtop convertible models with true 2+2 seating have joined the G6 sedan to create an entire family of expressive new Pontiac performers. The new Pontiac G6 hardtop convertible offers open-air driving as well as the security and refinement of a coupe. But just because you love top-down driving doesn't mean you need to give up performance. Both the G6 Coupe and G6 Convertible are available with either a 200 or 240 horsepower V6 engine with a choice of a 6-speed manual or 4-speed automatic. The new G6 Pontiac Convertible for fun in the sun, Hawaiian style.
And if you're like me and love convertibles, word is there's a G6 on the way with a retractable hardtop for about half the price of those expensive luxury cars. Speaking of cool convertible coupes, here's Anita with one of Chrysler's most successful models, the retro-styled PT Cruiser convertible.
Dale, the PT Cruiser is my kind of car. It's got lots of room, loads of fun, and it's a hot seller. It's been restyled for this model year and is available as a turbo, which takes the power on demand up to 230 horsepower.
Returning for 2006, the Chrysler PT Cruiser gives the face of Chrysler an all-new interior, improved performance, and a boost of power. Now rated at 230 horsepower and 245 pounds of torque. In addition, the 2006 Chrysler PT Cruiser gets an all-new interior. Included are new seat trims and fabric choices. New radio options for 2006 include a Boston Acoustic premium sound system that features 6 speakers and a subwoofer, as well as a 368-watt amplifier. Rear door speakers improve bass response. Also new for 2006 model year, all Chrysler PT Cruiser models get MP3 play capability. The Chrysler PT Cruiser will be available in 4 models for the 2006 model year. The Chrysler PT Cruiser, the Touring, the Cruiser Limited, and the PT Cruiser GT. The Cruiser Convertible is available in two models, the Touring and GT.
The best part of the PT Cruiser experience is that prices start, are you ready, under $15,000. Our thanks to the nice folks at Cutter Chrysler Dodge Jeep of Waipahu for giving us this pretty car to share with you. But wait, there's more exciting news from Chrysler. Let's look ahead with Bev.
Hey Anita, Chrysler has more hot news about new models coming our way. For all you Mopar maniacs, Dodge is making noise about bringing back the heritage-inspired Challenger muscle car, and it'll challenge the hot-selling Ford Mustang. It appears to be an updated clone to the original RT of the 70s. Hemi orange, carbon fiber hood, 6-speed manual gearbox, and 425 ponies. 0 to 60 in under 5 seconds. Yep, this thing's got a Hemi. Wow. Remember, you saw it here first on the road ahead.
Our old friend Bill just got back from the continent, where he was surprised to find so many cars with strange names. And that only got him to thinking, where did those car names come from? You'll find out coming up next on A Bunch of Maloney. We all know that the name Ford came from its famous founder, Henry Ford. Dodge from the Dodge brothers, and Chevrolet from famous race car driver Louis Chevrolet about the turn of the century. But what about all those other names? Where did they come from? Well, Bill got to thinking that very thing, and when he starts to thinking, it isn't long before he comes up with A Bunch of Maloney.
Dale is always moaning about my constant spying on some of the odder aspects of the world of cars. I find it interesting, and I can't help conjuring up some what-if situations as they bounce around my twisted mind. Like car names. We know that most cars were named after the man, very few women, who conceived and built the machines. Horace did the Dodge. Walter the Chrysler. Henry stands for Ford. And Count Antoine de la Motte Cadillac stands for the Cadillac. But, you know, so many of today's car names are so boring. V70, 3.2 CR, SC300SL, 300E. Unexciting. What happened to Roadmaster, Challenger, Bel Air? Well, if you're a student of the car game, you know that Gottlieb Daimler invented the automobile with his partner Carl Benz. His number one customer was a guy named Emil Jelinek, who had a 10-year-old daughter, Mercedes. Well, good old Gottlieb named his creation after his friend's daughter, and the rest, as they say on the History Channel, is history. So I was thinking, what if this method or format for naming cars became de rigueur, the industry-accepted way to name your car after your daughter? Why, you could be motoring around in a sexy summer tan drop top Pauline, or might own a top of the line high performance Linda with cruise control and heated seats. Hey Dad, can I use Mabel tonight?
No son, your sister has Mabel tonight. You can have Mabel tomorrow if you wash her real good and you know her heater's broken.
For sale, 2-ton Bertha. Heavy duty, go anywhere, do anything. Salesman, I can offer you a sweet deal on a new Annie.
airbag, sport suspension, tilt, very compact, and ready for zoom, zoom. I think I'll quit before I get in trouble. I'm Bill Maloney. See you next time.
We've hit the stop sign on another Ohana Road. We're glad you could come along. We hope you tell your friends that Ohana Road is on twice a week, every Saturday night at 6 and every Sunday night at 11, right here on Island Television KITV4. For the latest show info, check out the Ohana Road page every Friday in the Honolulu Advertiser's TGIF section, and you can visit us on the web at ohanaroad.net. That's .net. On the next Ohana Road, have you ever thought that it would be cool to have a vehicle that runs both on land and water? Well, we've got two on Concepts and Classics. We took the Ohana Road cameras to Beverly Hills, California, not to film movie stars, but instead the cars of the stars at the famous Peterson Automotive Museum. After that, it's back home to the islands as Hawaii's top funny man, Augie T, meets up with some local car guys on Hawaii Stars and Cars. All that plus a bunch of Maloney. Hope you'll join us. Until next time, I'm Dale Payson. Mahalo, everybody.
Now catch Ohana Road two nights a week, Saturday at 6 and Sunday at 11. Catering by Brew Moon, contemporary island cuisine and quality microbrews. Anita Hall's wardrobe provided by Cache. Special thanks to GO, Hawaii's low-fare airline and the official airline of Ohana Road. Cars provided by Cutter Family Auto Centers.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more automotive fun and information, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.